Fran Band.
Hey, it's Fran in the micro studio, my cozy little space. Doing a little tinkering around, but I wanted to show you something. And those of you who are purists will probably note that I'm breaking the covenant by wearing a Gibson SG with a Fender-branded strap. And others will point out that the strap is probably upside down because the lettering is the wrong way, but hey, you know, I like the buckle to be on this side, not down here, so just gonna have to live with it. But beyond that, other people might note, especially people who own Gibson SGs or know about the famous issue about Gibson SGs, is that I'm not actually holding on to the guitar and the headstock is not pointing to the floor. So, what? Yeah, look at this. It's just the guitar, it's sitting the right way. How is this done? Well, it's because I invented a special kind of guitar strap just for imbalanced guitars. SG is probably the most famous imbalanced guitar, but there are others. My short scale bass, the Fender, the Jaguar bass is also off kilter. And when you wear a guitar that has the center of mass too far towards the headstock, then when you let go of the neck, the headstock will just start sliding this way and point towards the floor. Very famously, Gibsons do that too. I overcame that by making this special kind of strap, which, although it looks just like a regular guitar strap, it's actually got a special clip that I sewed onto the strap on this side that goes under my belt. So all I do is when I put the guitar on, I clip it right here. You can see the little clip right here. See? Yeah. And so when I put the guitar on, I slip the clip underneath the belt. And so what happens is it's holding the weight of the guitar right here. Because if you hold the guitar just by this strap, the headstock won't fall to the ground. The problem is that if you try and balance the guitar evenly between both pegs, then the center of mass of the SG is too far to the left of the center point between the two pegs, and that causes the headstock to point towards the ground. If I take the clip off, then we'll go Gibson old school, so I'll make sure I'm clear of any kind of obstruction. I let go of the headstock and very famously, this is what happens. And so if you're not actually playing the guitar, but yeah, it's a very simple, elegant solution. And right now, people are going to say, Fran, why didn't you patent that? I mean, it works so well. It's so simple. Well, I have made many videos or made big comments in my videos about patenting ideas. The only people who say, Fran, you should patent that are people who've never patented anything, especially in the last 20 years, because there are some guys who are like, well, I had a lot of patents in the 70s and stuff. It was real easy. I've got like 20 patents. Well, these days, if you want to get a patent, you have to hire a patent attorney. And the patent search process takes about 6 months. It costs you about $10,000. And if you get awarded a patent, then people assume, oh, now you've got this commodity to sell. But what you don't realize is that when you actually get approved for the patent, your idea is made public. So in the patent files are accessible online. Anyone in the world can look through patent files and see patents that have been recently filed and do patent searches and such as that. And so your idea, whatever it is, becomes completely public, where anybody can just steal that idea and make the product or make something very similar to the product. And then this is the third part of it, is that there are no patent police. So there's like no international agency that is going to search for anyone violating your patent. You, who have paid the $10,000 and gone through the process of getting the patent and everything, it is up to you and you alone to police your own patent. So you have to constantly scour the world looking for anybody who might be infringing upon your patent. And then when you find someone who is infringing upon your patent, you have to go through the extremely expensive process and sometimes impossible process of international patent litigation with large corporations and entities in far-flung areas of the globe. you have to have very deep pockets. We're talking millions of dollars just to maintain your patent. So for those of you who say that I should patent the little guitar strap thing, forget it. I put my ideas out there open source. However, having made the video, I claim ownership of the idea. If anyone wants to make guitar straps with the Frantone clip for the SG, I would be very happy to accept my due royalty from said strap. But if you own an SG or any other kind of guitar that's, you know, headstock heavy, yeah, you can do the same thing I did. You know, buy a clip online, sew it to the strap or rivet it to the strap, put it, you know, right in the spot here where the guitar sits for you. Done deal. So anyway, I thought you might enjoy my little invention and a little demonstration of my new little studio. I've got some other stuff on this side. My theremin, keyboards, and mixing console and stuff is over there. So yeah, we'll be seeing a little more of this room in the upcoming months and years to come. So anyway, thanks for watching. I'm Fran. Thanks to all the patrons down on the Patreon, making all these videos possible, including this one. Thank you, thank you, thank you, everybody on Patreon. And I'm always very thankful for all the people who support the channel. And we're gonna have some exciting stuff coming up through the summer. All right, I'm Fran. I'll be back either here or in the office or in the lab somewhere in the Fran lab real soon. Bye! In the lab. That's where I work. In the lab. Go berserk. In my lab. Try. Track 4. Here we go. Take 1. Fran Band.